To be honest, not really sure what I was going to do with this piece of oak. It was kind of speaking to me, make a box. So, why not indeed? Using a DIY plywood bandsaw sled, going to shape this piece of oak into a longer rather than squarish piece of stock. And I'm not going to take the corners off all around it. Just going to put that onto the lathe and shape it out. I like to keep my fingers well away from that blade. Certainly not going to have any accidents pop up. Starting off with a stock between centres and using my Hunter Tools roughing tool. I don't always use the same tool for roughing. I use a myriad of different types of tools depending on what sort of stock and the situation. And there are no real do's or don'ts. You can decide to do whatever you like when you're wood turning. If a tool fits you and you feel it more comfortable in using, go for it. It could be a bowl gouge, it could be whatever you decide, scrapers, the whole box and die. Now I'm shaping a tenon on the end of this piece of stock and I'm going to turn it around and put it in the truck. So I've got a pretty good tight hold on the workpiece, because this particular box is going to be longer than it is shorter, so without having an easy hold device, I'm just going to have that chuck take most of the pressure of holding the piece tight. I'll use the tailstock up the face place as well, just to hold it in place for as long as I can. Yeah, it could be a lot safer than having the thing fly off the lathe. Using a square half inch angled skew just to shape that tenon into a nice even shape. It's important to get them pretty well accurate so that the chuck can hold it very, very tight. Piece is now mounted and held tight in that chuck. Tailstock pushed right up to the end. I'm starting now to really rough this out and get it into a nice round shape. A few of my subscribers have asked what got me involved in wood turning. After 40 years of running my computer software companies in Australia and then selling them out and moving into the United States with my new wife Robin, I took up some woodworking, but mainly wood turning. I've got a habit in my life to be involved with what I'm 100% head down, bum up, as they say. So wood turning is no exception. I've really put my heart and soul into this, and soon after that, started this YouTube channel, which has been a very pleasurable experience in both platforms. So, yep, from Australia for most of my life to the US, and certainly enjoying every day. And removing the end of the piece so that I can remove the tailstock and gain access to the shape of the top of the box. I personally like to use the Ellsworth grind bowl gouge on the outside of these ball type shapes. I did try for a while there, to be honest, using skews. I could never really get the hang of that skew tool. It's going to take a lot more of my practice to make those shapes true and form. Skews are a very, very difficult tool, and they do need a lot of practice. So meanwhile, the bowl gouge does suit my purposes. You've really got to be very careful using it on left and right hand turns. It can catch very, very easily. Keep it sharp as usual. Putting the standing finishing off the outside of this ball, using the parting tool to split the two halves apart, then hollowing out each piece, as you can see. Space or area between the two halves really has to be very clean and straight cuts for the two halves to rejoin. I use this very, very fine pointing tool to just shave off those edges so they're very, very flat and smooth. Using the Japanese saw to just cut right through the two halves, and then I can deal with both halves separately. Now using the 3/8 small Ellsworth bowl gouge just to hollow out the bottom of that ball. I have to say at this stage you've got to be very, very careful when moving the bowl gouge right to the outer edge there. It can easily kick back or slide back and ruin the whole rim, which is pretty well much of a disaster for a box, because you've got so much to play with in terms of waste material. See here now that I've got that side pretty well hollowed out, and now using the lid to get that hollowed out. I've opted to use the vacuum truck, and this particular truck head I'm using, as you can see, it just sucks straight in. I need a little bit of a small one, so I changed over to the green one, as I call it. It's about a 2-inch diameter, and held that tight. I'm actually making sure that the piece is held straight into that vacuum truck so that it doesn't wobble. You just hold your thumb against the rim there and give it a bit of tap left and right for it to be spinning true. Did some research before I settled on the frugal vacuum truck for holding pieces on the headstock, particularly small pieces like this. It's an extremely handy tool to have. Well worth the money. I think I only paid something like $250, $300 for the whole kit and caboodle. That's including the vacuum pump itself, which holds a piece in that chuck very, very tight. So nearing the end of hollowing out the lid here, and finishing off with some finishing wax and some finishing polish. Really not going to go to a great deal of finishes, just like to have these two products take most of the brunt for how it looks at the end of the day. Final scooping out of the bottom half of the box ball, and then truing up the two pieces and have the finishing wax on that. Acks Abrasive, as you see, that's the stuff I use. It's extremely good. Just put a coat of that on your piece, and then the Acks finishing polish on top is all that's needed. Makes the pieces look real nice. Sometimes go for the Mylar friction polish on top of the Acks paste and Acks polish. Certainly makes it shine at the end of the day. So if you're looking for a shiny finish, Mylar friction polish is the way to go. Lid nearly came off of my hands there, just by the way, but managed to grasp it before it flew off. So getting close to the end of the video here, guys. Please, if you're new to the channel, wouldn't mind having your subscription and at least liking the video. Any comments are most welcome. Like talking to my subscribers. Honestly, look forward to reading the comments that you guys leave behind in my videos. There have been some extremely nice accolades, and I can see that you really like to follow my channel here, which is what YouTube's all about, after all. So at the end of this video here, I've got some stills and some shots just showing off the product as it came out. Really appreciate you watching this video. Looking forward to you all being with me next week. Cheers, guys.